Yun nga kasi yun nga, we were talking about savings first, diba? And of course, that's the most basic part. But how do you get from that mindset na okay, I want to save to actually getting that first million plus plus?
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening kung nasan makikinig panig ng mundo. Ito po ang Kaasenso with Gerard and Mich. Ako po si Gerard de la Peña.
Ako po si Michelle Orosa-Ople. Of course, mga kwentong ika-asenso, ika-uunlad at ikagaganda ng buhay.
At syempre, ikatataba ng ating brain cells. Gusto nating lahat yan, partner. Exciting episode ngayon. Bakit nga ba?
Nakakatuwa. May makikilala tayo today na sikat na content creator pagdating sa larangan ng finance. Aba, walang iba kundi si Ready to Adult PH. Nako, kaya sobrang na nakita ng ating radar ito. Ay, kabata, partner! 27 years old and yet a portfolio of already millions. And pag sinabi namin millions, peso-seso-ses, millions. How did she do it? Grabe.
Sabihin na natin, ito ang The Road to 1 Million episode. Yes. Diba? Why not?
Simulan na natin ngayon, partner. I mean, let's all learn. Paano ba kumita ng 1 million? Mahigit.
Ayan. Yes, kaya mga ka-asenso, ito na po, Charmaine De Leon.
Okay, welcome, Charm De Leon. Ready to Adult PH. My gosh, nako, what a privilege to have you here on our show.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me. Hi, everyone.
Hi, grabe. Okay, let's start first with what got you started sa finance. You're so young. 27 lang siya, guys. Grabe.
Nasaan tayo ng 27 tayo, di ba?
Yes, yun. Pero you're so well-versed in finance. You'll see a video link down below. How did you start?
When I started my first parang serious businesses after college, parang I was 21, I really wanted to work on the marketing side, on the operations, but among the partners, they really felt that I gravitated or I was good at handling the finances. So I became the finance director of my businesses. In four other businesses offline, I do all the finances. And despite being in business finance, I was very bad at managing my own personal finances. So after working for a couple of years, owning your own business, I felt like, oh, I'm earning a decent amount, but wala akong savings. So I literally searched like, why am I not saving? And that's how I got into the loophole, parang into the personal finance realm of YouTube in particular. But I was always watching, at first, before, I was always watching US-based content creators. So yeah, that's my, I don't have formal background on finance, educational background. I am an architect. I'm an architect by profession, but I'm not practicing. Wow. Yeah, pero I did get the chance to practice, but yeah, it's all real world experiences na lang, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Pero ano yung naging trigger mo kung bakit suddenly bigla mo naisip na ay dapat mag-save na ako? Ano yung naging trigger sa'yo?
I feel like it's that feeling na you keep looking at your bank account pero it's not really growing, but you say to yourself, I'm earning a decent wage, I'm earning a decent income, pero wala, hindi talaga, like 2-3 years in and I'm not really earning, I was already thinking about buying my first car and I was struggling to realize that I couldn't, based lang kasi on my timeline, I was already planning to. But yeah, I was really sad to know that parang hindi pa pala kaya, and why is that? And that's when I realized it all went to food and travel. We're in my early 20s. Until now, ata. Relate din naman ako. So, personal experience.
So, di ba, after college, di ba, you took up architecture, natapos mo naman, nakagraduate ka naman. Ano yung, bakit ka nag-business? Bakit hindi ka nag-practice?
Oo.
Sayang, di ba? Pag sinabing arkitekto ka, di ba, it could be lucrative, but nag-business ka. Yeah.
Yeah. In architecture kasi, unlike other courses, there's no OJT when you're in college, but there is apprenticeship, 2 years apprenticeship after you graduate. And typically, 2 years of that apprenticeship or worth 2 years of hours is you're not paid well. Or and it's not against the law. It's just because you're being a trainee or you're trying to be mentored by other professionals. Mm-hmm. And as ako kasi yung breadwinner, so I couldn't you know, just earn, like, I think at my time it was like 3 to 5K a month. Mm-hmm. And I really couldn't take home that pay kasi I'm the breadwinner, and I really tried to find ways how can I earn money. And I've always been an entrepreneur since I was a kid. I was always business minded, like candy, cookies. I was renting out magazines. I was, you know, selling. I had an online Instagram shop before. So I was always very parang entrepreneurial, and I felt like I could do more with that talent or skill set, and I could still do all the qualifications that I needed to take the board exam on the side na lang. So I really didn't have my focus there anymore because I had to focus on earning money. So parang napilitan, but very grateful that I was pushed to that challenge.
Mm-hmm. Curious ako, anong klaseng businesses yung hinandle mo nun?
So being an online seller, I was part of a couple of local bazaars here in Cebu, but I felt like it was lacking, especially if comparing it to the bazaars in Manila. So mm-hmm. I was thinking, bakit wala tayong like big bazaar and, you know, an air-conditioned place? It's just really a bazaar. Kasi yung mga bazaar namin before, it's just a side thing, like sa concert or sa rave or sa corporate event, may maliit na bazaar for income generating nila. Mm-hmm. But wala talagang buyers doon sa mga events na yon. So I really wanted to put up an avenue for small businesses, online businesses. So I created a pop district bazaar, which was a seasonal na life food and lifestyle bazaar. So wow. It lasts for like 2 to 3 days. So it's like the bazaars that happen in World Trade Center. Mm-hmm. And then shortly after that, like a few weeks after, I got invited to partner with Sugbu Mercado, which is very similar to like a Mercado Central there in Manila. So that one is like every weekend and it's food, and yeah, we're still operating until today. So that's Technically my full-time job before.
So amazing. Mm-hmm. I wonder also though, how you're really comfortable with numbers siguro, no?
Yes. Yeah, mm-hmm. I think since I was a kid, I was exposed to money and numbers, and I loved math as a subject. So parang that's why I think I gravitated towards that, even if I wanted to be more creative and parang marketing seems more fun. Yeah, pinilit na ako mag-finance, so director. So okay, I embrace it.
Thanks, okay, sana all, partner.
Diba? Ako kasi ako Charmaine, BS math kasi ako. Bobo sa
math. Wow, okay.
Bobo sa math. Kaya ako naging reporter, ganun. Well, I'm covering business, so medyo struggle sa akin ng numbers. Well, anyway, di ba nabanggit mo na, ayun nga, nanood ka ng mga iba't ibang content creators about saving. And then what's next? Ano nangyari?
After a few years of watching them, it's so hard kasi when you watch other content creators abroad kasi you keep on converting everything to Philippine peso, mm-hmm. from, you know, to BIR, mm-hmm. yung IRS nila and everything like that. So parang for me, why wasn't there someone that I could relate to, like someone around my age or especially like me as a millennial, parang you relate to more people your age. No offense, pero like it's different with mostly kasi the space is dominated by older people, like maybe like 50s, et cetera. So parang I wanted to represent in a way. And also because I noticed that a lot of my close friends, like in my inner circle lang, keeps asking me about these things already, mm-hmm. like, you know, how to invest, how to save, ganun. So parang one day I got the same exact question from two of my friends. Mm-hmm. And then I just screenshotted the conversation from one to the next. And then the second person said, parang, you should just make this into a YouTube video. Tapos link na lang is send mo. So I was like, oh nga no, that's pretty smart. So yeah, that's when it started. And especially it got pushed more during the pandemic because I started like before pandemic and I got encouraged more during the pandemic because ang dami ka talagang need for financial literacy, diba, during the pandemic. So parang, okay, I have to take this seriously. There, other than myself or like for my own benefit, may maidudulot talagang value to for other people. So okay. Yeah.
Oh, mm-hmm. Ang galing lang na ano na you caught that na people really need to be able to relate then to the content that they're seeing. And lalo na
yeah.
Actually, ngayon, yun nga, 'di ba, one of the discussions you were having, no, partner, is that ang daming excess na pera ngayon, yung mga madalas ginagastos dati sa labas-labas. Now suddenly you have it at home.
Low maintenance lifestyle na, yeah.
Yes,
I agree. Yeah.
I guess a lot of people are also asking themselves, but di ako nakasave. May 10-10, 11-11.
Speaking of that question, ano, Charmaine, speaking of that question, di ba, ikaw nagkaroon ka ng parang self-assessment. So good, nagkaroon ka ng self-awareness. Tapos ngayon nakaka-relate ka na doon sa siguro medyo ka-age mo or at least malapit sa age mo. Sa assessment mo, yung people of your generation, well, technically millennials din tayo eh, or a bit
Tulo.
Older.
Nakaganyan tayo sa millennials.
Nakaganyan tayo sa millennials. Pero ikaw, sa assessment mo, yung mga millennials, saan sila nagkamali? Bakit napaka-pervasive or napaka-common?
Hirap.
Yung mga millennials yeah. na lang ibon, anong maling ginagawa nila?
Ako, I personally believe it's really systemic kasi the lack of financial literacy is really one. So that's why I'm trying to bridge the gap somehow to like people who can relate to me. But other than that, it's really things that attract like instant gratification. Kasi that was me. Like, okay, I was culture shocked from barely earning in college to earning a decent wage after college. Parang, oh, I have all this money. Like, let's spend it all. So that was my mindset. And I don't doubt that that's what other people's mindsets are also because they don't know any better. Mm-hmm. They don't know what to do with it. A lot of my other friends who are kuripot, they save, but they also tell me, like, I don't know what I'm saving for. Like, I don't know how to invest. I'm just really saving because mm-hmm. I feel like that's the right thing to do. So it's really... the lack of education and also the temptations sa paggastos. Like before pandemic, ako grabe yung travel ko talaga, yung eating out. But I'm not so into like the budol or the shopping, but that's also the reason for others. So ang daming pwedeng pagkagastosan and it's so hard to earn. So I think that's one.
Correct. So, ito, what was your step one in getting to that mindset? Okay, let's start building the savings.
Yeah, so for me, I really had to have a goal. It was the car in my experience. It doesn't have to be that big or that small for other people. But it's important kasi to have something that you're saving up for. It can be retirement, it can be for your future family or etc. Diba? Pero it's hard kasi to drive when you don't know your destination. Parang ganon. So I feel like that was a good driving force for me to save. And then the biggest thing that helped me save was just creating a separate account where it's all savings. Kasi before, I only had like one account for my income, lahat expenses, you know, all the credit card bills and utility bills dun kukunin. And that's why I don't see it fluctuate. I don't see it growing or, you know, hindi ko nafe-feel nga I'm actually saving. So once I created that separate account and then when I get my income, save agad, that's when I really felt na, oh, ang laki pala ng difference. I'm actually saving. I can really see it now. So naganado ako to continue because of that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Ako ito, I'll jump na to the ano, to the big guns.
Yeah, the million peso big question guns. Na ba yan, partner?
Huh?
Is it the million peso question?
Ito na, the million peso question, quite literally, partner. Yun nga, kasi yun nga, we were talking about savings first, diba? And of course, that's the most basic part. But how do you get from that mindset na, okay, I want to save, to actually getting that first million plus plus. By the way, she has 3 million in her portfolio, in her entire portfolio, and we will link the video down below so that you can get to see and learn from her as well. But dun muna tayo sa first million na yun. How did you even decide to get to that that goal?
Yeah, so when I was aiming to save my first million, I wasn't even thinking about investing yet. I was just really hoarding money in my savings account, which I know now that is not the smartest. But for what helped me get there was that reverse engineering the numbers. So parang 1 million kasi seems so daunting, diba? It seems so scary. Mm. So when I realized na, for example, the common number that I use is parang you can save parang 10,000 a month for eight plus years and then you can get to a million. So parang people will think, oh, it's not that impossible pala. I can just save regularly this amount and then I can get there in 8 years. So parang for me, okay, let's reverse engineer this. How much do I need to be saving a month to get there? So parang you break the goal down to smaller bits of goal para it's more attainable. And then from there, the one I shared earlier wherein I prioritized my savings was also a big help. And then lastly, it was always looking for other income streams. So I always encourage people to have at least 2 income streams. Like, I think it was very evident during the pandemic that it was we're not safe. Like, even the most seemingly steady jobs were not safe with the pandemic, diba? So parang it's so important for me to keep on looking for other streams of income. Mm-hmm. So other sources of income kasi will really drastically help you get to your goal or to save. We're always thinking of reducing our expenses, but there's just so much that we can reduce until we're barely eating anything anymore. Yeah, diba? Yeah. Like kanin at patis na lang. So like, I think it's people don't realize na exponentially higher yung possibility to earn if they to save if they earn another source of income. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And at this point, you still had your businesses, right? Which ones there yung hanggang ngayon meron mo pa?
Yeah, so all my businesses are still there until now, but they've laid low because of the pandemic lang. Mm-hmm. But they're all still operating in smaller scales though, but those were, YouTube was not in the picture back then, so it was all just my businesses. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Ang galing na you're able to maintain all of these sources of income at this time. Partners.
You talked about multiple sources of income. You have businesses, iba't iba, you have your YouTube channel. How do you manage your time? How do you strike a balance?
I think I was just fortunate enough to have a great team behind all my businesses, like which mm-hmm. I've built over the last 6 years that we've run the businesses. So it's really hard to find those people, but once you do and you can finally, you know, just look at the bigger picture stuff or just do like executive stuff na lang talaga, like I don't manually do all the things that I used to do, then it's a big help talaga to keep on expanding, to be able to use your time wisely in other areas. Like right now, almost 80% of my time is in YouTube, creating content, meeting with brands, going on interviews like this, and then mga 20% na lang yung time ko with my 4 other businesses. Yeah.
And by nature of the pandemic na nasa bahay ka rin talaga most of the time now.
That's true. Mm-hmm. Wala na kang masyadong travel time, so that's also a big help.
Right. Eto, what were your biggest challenges coming into that the million space?
I think it was really the temptation. Yeah, like I remember like my nag-post ata ako sa Facebook or Twitter na parang okay, 2018 or 2019 ba yon, I'm not gonna travel much, I'm not gonna eat much, but like first 3 months of the year pa lang wala na, I broke na my New Year's resolution. Yeah. So it's really the discipline kasi I think I think that's why it's very important to instill these, even with kids or even with teenagers who don't have much money to manage yet. Mm-hmm. Kasi the discipline and the attitude that you bring all throughout, parang if you're smart with your money, not naman to the extent na you're very kuripot, impractical kuripot, but like yung ayos lang, if you bring that all throughout, I feel like you're so much better off because of the attitude or discipline lang that you have. Even I think I always hear that quote na parang I'm just paraphrasing, but parang if you can't handle your money at 20,000 salary, you're still gonna be bad at money at 100,000 salary, diba? Like it's really the attitude and discipline. It's not the amount that you earn.
Mm-hmm. Ayun ang pinagtataka ko, sabi mo na break mo yung New Year's resolution mo and yet you still made it. So ano ba ang tamang mindset dyan?
Yeah, so I quickly realized that I didn't want to compromise my lifestyle. I loved eating out, I still loved traveling, but I needed ways to still save. So that's why ako personally, I just keep on trying to earn more and more. Like I know that I have the ability to parang yun nga, I have an entrepreneurial mindset and parang I can madiskarte ako to find money. So I'm focusing on that instead of making myself suffer na parang okay, like one meal lang ako eating out a month, like hindi talaga kaya. I really love that. So yeah, if you're someone who, you know, loves shopping, maybe give yourself an allowance and never go beyond that. Para lang, you know, it's still within the budget. So I still really believe in the reward system then. So my reward is eating out and traveling before. Yeah.
Gusto ko yung reward system. And I guess it's really about setting the boundaries lang so you can have that good quality of life na na you also want naman for yourself. Kasi, yeah. Ako, ang hirap naman na ang dami kong pera tapos di ko rin na-enjoy in some way. Mm-hmm. Diba? Oo.
Yes.
So, ito, what would you advise yung mga tao na wala pa nga doon sa 10,000, 20,000, much less millions?
Yeah. I feel like I get this question a lot, like, you know, I'm still a student, like, what should I do first? Mm-hmm. Like, how can I invest? Ganun. And I always say invest in yourself, mm-hmm. especially like in your knowledge. Kasi if you're well equipped with the knowledge on how to do things, when they actually happen, they're much easier to do, if that makes sense. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So parang like me, I subconsciously kept learning about how to manage my money and my businesses. Kasi growing up, I was always very madiskarte and racket here and there. So parang unconsciously na-train yung brain ko how to do those things. And it really helped me when it came to my businesses. Kasi starting a business, like I was 21 or 22 and all my other business partners are like 30s, 40s. It's really hard to keep up with them. And you also have to learn fast, think on your feet, diba? And you don't want to disappoint them, especially because you're young. So parang preparing yourself for those through learning about the fundamentals or learning about how it is, even if wala ka pang pera to invest mismo, I think is very important. Yeah.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Ito, partner, we've talked about the first step to 1 million. So ngayon, ang tanong ko, kamusta ang road to 1 million? How difficult was it?
it was difficult at the beginning kasi it's a change in lifestyle, definitely it's a change in mindset. And once you get the ball rolling, I feel like it's going to be so much easier. That's why it's, 'di ba, they always say the first step is always the hardest. Once you already do the first steps, tapos you see your balance in your bank account growing, it's so much easier kasi you have na tangible proof na you're actually doing something right. So right, parang yeah, magaganado ka talaga. Yeah. It's addicting actually to save and invest. It's very addicting, yeah.
Mm-mm. Curious ako, what does your portfolio look like? I mean, in terms of ano, just in broad strokes.
My portfolio mostly right now it's in real estate. I think almost 70% is in real estate. Mm-hmm. Tapos a good chunk is in stocks as well. I don't know na how much right now, maybe 20% in stocks, and then maybe 5% in cash, and mm-hmm. then the rest of the 5% is like in funds and in crypto. So it's mostly I am a believer. I hope yung goal ko talaga is to retire with a 50% stocks and 50% real estate portfolio, like more or less, but of course, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Stocks, do you trade actively or passive investor ka sa stocks?
I have a few accounts. So I have long-term investing accounts and I have shorter-term investing accounts, like yung pang swing trade lang, but I don't check it every day. Like majority, I have maybe 4 accounts and then 3 of them I just check them quarterly. Mm-hmm. And then isa lang yung parang I call it like parang my gambling account. Parang maliit lang yung pera nandun. It's just like it's money that I can afford to lose, and it's just really I'm challenging myself lang to get us to a certain amount, parang ganon. But for the most part, I am a long-term investor both in the US and PSE. So, yeah.
Mm,
very good kung batang to. May stocks partner.
Very, very passive.
Yeah. Actually, parang people think na parang when it comes to stocks, you have to check it every day, ganon. Pero ako, personally, I feel like you can still gain a lot of it even if you just yun check it once every quarter, once every month, ganun. Kasi we see in the TV, di ba? Parang ang daming screens, ang daming charts, parang it's very intense, Wall Street, ganun. So parang people get turned off kasi parang it's so scary and intimidating, yeah.
Oh, ako personally, I think it's quite healthy to not look at it all the time.
Yeah.
Lalo na ngayon,
it's
grabe.
It's not good for your mental health to keep looking at it every day.
Pero that is to check for opportunities. Kasi ako, pag nakita ko yung account ko na talagang malaki yung negative, dead man na, aakyat din naman niya. So I check every day, especially ngayon na nagtitape natin tong episode na to, paakyat ang stocks. Ang saya-saya, nakaka-motive.
I check the watcher every day, pero not my account. Yung parang prices, yeah.
Uh-oh. To check lang for opportunities kasi sayang, baka merong paakyat na, kunin natin yan, ganyan. So, kanya-kanya rin tayong strategy. Pero, saan ka natuto mag-stocks?
I know it doesn't sound professional, pero YouTube. Okay. Most of my knowledge, YouTube, I've attended some webinars, I read, parang I Google everything that I don't know, I just ask Google. And yeah, I've gotten to a point wherein parang I'm comfortable, I know what I'm doing for my own self lang ha, not to handle other people's money. But for myself, I'm confident enough to na I know what I'm doing just through online sources. So, yeah.
Mga Kaasenso, that's how you do it.
Yes. That's how you do it these days. Lahat na sa Google na. At definitely, ayan, of course, sa YouTube. Ayan, we'll put her channel din down below. I think ang ganda ng selection ng videos mo is not only about your journey, pero a lot of concepts and actually, to your point, fundamentals din.
Yes,
na pwedeng matutunan ng mga tao. So ito, just I guess to wrap things up, what would you advise someone who's scared to even start? Kasi it seems daunting talaga sa simula.
Yeah. What I've noticed is that the biggest advice I can give is that, or the biggest insight I can give is that investing doesn't take millions. Like everyone needs to invest. You can invest for as low as 50 to 5,000 pesos nowadays, diba? So, we think kasi when investing, pang mayaman lang yan or pang millionaire lang yan, especially if we're talking about it in this sense. And I feel like that's what's intimidating. Also, that parang first step lang talaga yung you need to understand where you're investing. Tapos the rest are quite easy na. It's not a very super high maintenance type of like, I feel like a business takes more energy and time out of you than investing, diba? For most vehicles, that is. So yeah, don't be afraid because it's really not that scary and it's not that hard, but you just need to understand the fundamentals and you need to be prepared with what will happen to your money. So don't also blindly invest to things that, you know, I will say or other content creators or Facebook groups will say. Do your own due diligence talaga para walang it's no one's fault.
Right.
Yeah. Oo. You can't blame anyone. Yeah.
Doon pa lang sa goals, iba-iba na yan eh, 'di ba?
Yes, yeah.
The way to get
walang one size fits all.
Right. Yeah. I'm wondering and I'm really curious and I'm also part excited. Where do you see yourself in the next coming years? I mean, the goals you've already had right now, grabe. So
yeah.
Where do you see yourself?
Wow. Lately, I'm a very new content creator. I've only been around for around 2 years, but I've seen the potential talaga of investing more of my time and energy into YouTube in particular or content creation. And I feel like I want to expound that. I'm in the works na yung podcast ko and also creating another YouTube channel na still catered to personal finance and investing, real estate, entrepreneurship, but hopefully easier pa to digest than my current content. So more fun content on that channel. And yeah, I hope to grow that media company to reach more Filipinos about financial literacy talaga. So,
Galing. At aabangan namin yan. We will provide the links down below sa lahat ng channels ni Charmaine. Ladies and gentlemen, Charmaine De Leon, Ready to Adult PH. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. This was so fun.
Thank you.
Maraming salamat, Charmaine De Leon, Ready to Adult PH. My gosh, ang dami kong natutunan, partner. At ang dami rin, medyo tumusok sa akin, ano?
Oo, talaga, it doesn't really matter kung sino ang ating, kung sino yung ating resource person. Kesyo, mas bata ito sa atin, kasing edad natin, o mas matanda. Talagang, knowledge is knowledge, wisdom is wisdom, at ito na yun, di ba? Napakadaming takeaways, ano?
Mm-mm. And wala talagang tapon eh. If you really take the time to learn, ika nga ni Charm kanina, if you really take the time to invest in the knowledge, learn the fundamentals, kaya may pera ka o wala, it will be ingrained sa'yo eh. So that when you start handling the money, alam mo na kung paano siya palakihin. Tapos ang ganda na sinabi niya, pag habang lumalaki kasi siya, and I can attest to this, habang lumalaki yung amount sa bank account mo, ganyan, nagiging nakaka-addict, in a good way, na parang pwede pala, number one. And number two, kaya ko pala, di ba? Kaya ko pala yung kapasidad to be able to say na, oh, naabot ko pala. E di what more if I add a bit more, di ba? 10 more, 10,000 more, 20,000 more, di ba?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, pag sinabi ni Mitch na nakaka-addict, nakaka-motivate, di ba? Ikaw na, pag nakita mo yung pag nakita mo yung running balance ng iyong siguro yung bank account, di ba? Parang nakakatuwa talaga na lumalaki siya, di ba? Nakaka-motivate.
Mm-hmm. Share ko nga short experience, one of the things na na-affect ako before, laki na. Tapos biglang nagka-emergency, I had to withdraw a huge amount. It was a medical emergency. And parang na-realize ko, and it took a while, na-realize ko, ang sakit pala mawala na malaki, number one. Kaya may mga insurance talaga tayo kailangan pag-usapan, di ba? And second, sabi ko, it was hard to get back on that road ulit to go back. Pero kaya, yun nga, you take that first step forward ulit. And ngayon, more than pa yung na-save ko na. Pero sabi ko, madali kasi na ma-discourage, madaling hala nawala, ang pinag-ipunan ko yon, 'di ba? And ako, that's why it's so important na when you're gonna use your money, make sure talaga na one, you have your emergency fund. And second na wag kang papasok sa bagay na mawawala yung pera mo na hindi mo alam, di ba? Like, yung huwag kang papasok sa bagay na hindi mo alam, hindi mo napag-aralan. Kasi masakit mawalan ng pera and then to start again, ang hirap, di ba? Pero yun, ang galing. Ang galing lang how si Charm was able to really get herself on that track. And the most important part for me was just having the discipline. Kasi yung discipline will help tide you through the tough times, di ba? Na parang kaya ko ba to, konti lang kinikita ko, or konti lang pumapasok. Pero yung disiplina, ang galing, sabi niya, that's the best weapon talaga that you can have and the best place to start with. To really just get your mindset in order.
Dito, partner, ito yung pinakamagat ng takeaway kasi tinanong ko sa kanya saan siya natuto. Sabi pa niya, it sounds so unprofessional, pero...
Yan.
Ano, YouTube lang niya. Ginugle lang. Di, alam yung mga so ito, it doesn't really matter kung ginugle mo lang yan o nakita mo lang sa YouTube. Ang pinakamahalaga talaga, you invested time, nag-research ka, umefort ka para matuto ka, di ba? So, yan yung mga opportunities na dapat talaga eh hindi natin pinapalampasan. No? Katulad ng pag-video channel na to, di ba?
Yes. Okay. Na, the fact na nandito kayo already means you've taken 2 steps forward dito sa ating journey ng financial freedom, di ba, and financial literacy. What did you learn? Please type it down below. Ano yung mga favorite na learning nyo dito kay Charm? And of course, we'll be linking down yung video niya on yung kanyang 3M portfolio, di ba? Napaka-interesting din nun. And links to her channel and her podcast. Supportahan natin yung podcast niya. And lahat ng mga ibang... lahat ng mga ibang channels para matuto tayong lahat kung paano maghawak at magpalaki ng pera. O di ba, hindi lang sa paghahawak, kailangan palakihin siya.
That's right. Oo, yan kaya mga Kaasenso, kung natuwa kayo sa episode namin, next week po ulit, magkita-kita ulit tayo. Ang aming fresh episodes po ay bumabagsak tuwing alas 12 ng tanghali kapag Sabado. Kaya kita-kits po ulit dito sa Kaasenso with Gerard and Mich. Ako po si Gerard de la Peña.
Ako po si Michelle Orosa-Ople. God bless mga Kaasenso.